Hello everyone, welcome back to Code Step by Step. My name is Anil. In this part of Angular, we will learn how we can create a basic Angular form, get the value from this form and display on our HTML form. So keep in mind, this is not the complete Angular forms tutorial. Whenever we will learn Angular complete form tutorial, it will take around 10 videos because in Angular, forms is a vast and a complex topic. In Angular, we have two types of form, reactive and template based. And after that, we will learn how we can validate them, how we can pre-fill the forms, how we can disable the input fields and many things. So it will take around 10 videos. So we will learn all this topic in the upcoming videos. But for a moment, we will focus on the basic things about the form, because at least we have to know how we can get the data from forms, how we can create it and how we can display it at least. So let's start with the points of this video. First of all, we will learn how we can import the form module and where we have to import it. After that, we will create a simple form. We will get the data from a form and we will display it on our screen. So first question is where we have to import the form module. So we have to import it in our module file. So where and what is our module file, which is app.module.ts. Keep in mind, if you have multiple modules, so maybe if you have a big project and you created the auth module, you created the user module and kind of things. So whenever you need this form in specific module, let's say in user module or in auth module, that time you will import the forms in that module. But now we have only one module, which is app module. So we will import our form here. So just simply put here, import something from Angular form, and we will put here forms module, and we can just register them in imports like this. So that's it for app.module.ts. We can close it. After that, let's create a basic form, which is a basic HTML form. So let me add here a form, and after that we can add some input fields. Let's say input type can be text, name can be, let's say, user. You can add a placeholder, enter user name. We can close this form. After that, we can create two more forms, and we can change the text also. Enter so let's change the name first, user email, and at the last password. Same thing we can just do here, enter user email, password, and that's it. So now let's see how it actually look like on our screen. So here you can see that all fields are coming in a single column. So this is not a good practice. So what we can do here, even you can use the style here, but for quick and easy solution, what I'm going to do, I am putting here br tag. Keep in mind, in actual project, you can just do maintain this space with the CSS, because here in specifically in this video, I am focusing on the logic for forms. That's why I'm not adding the CSS and all. And at the last, we can again add these two forms, two fields actually, BR. And at the last one, let me add here a button, and we can write here any text, let's say register or something. Now it will look like much better. So now what we can do here, so first of all, we have to define the form name. So let me add here hash basic form, and just simply register it with the ng form. After that, we can just create a function to register our to submit our form. So just define a event for submit, and just simply put here our form name, let's say function name, which is, let's say, get data. And what we will pass in this parameter, we will pass basic form, right? And after that, that's okay. So now we have to just register this get data function. So just create this function inside our get data, and for a moment, let's make a console dot warn. And what we will console here, the data which is coming inside our form, from form to this function. So let me just add here data, but now it will ask me for the type. So let's use this ng type. So I already imported that, so I can just remove it and import it again. Import something from the rate angular forms and just simply put here ng form, and we can simply define the type of this data. Great. After doing this, keep in mind there is a one more thing, which is we have to define ng model with the every field. So if we will not define this ng model with the field, then it will not consider it as a part of form. So we have to define the fields, ng model with the all fields. And now let's see what we are getting here. So whenever I'm registering it, you will find that we are getting a ng form with a lots of data. So do we need all this data? Actually not. For a moment, we don't need. So we need just value. We can just get this value like this. And now you will find that we have blank value for user, email and password. We are agree on it because the all fields are blank. So I can just put here name, let's say Anil, email address, let's say Anil@test. After that, let's say password is 123 ABC or something. Now I'm registering on it and you will find that we are getting the data. Great. So we got the data. How we can display this data here? All right. So this is again a simple topic. So first of all, let's define some property name, let's say user data or something. Right, and it can be any, and by default it have the empty object. So now let's just simply define this dot user data equal to data, and inside our HTML page let's define a UL li, and here we can put here user data. I hope I just write this complete and okay, this is the user data, that's fine. And after that, what we can do here, dot, let's put here dot name, and you will find that whenever I am just putting here name, this is visible here, it should be user, not name, right? So let's say we have Anil here, and you can see that Anil is visible here after from here. So now what we can do here, let's make two more lists and display the data. Let's say user, email and password. And now you will find that this is working fine. So let me add here, let's say Anil, email Anil@test.com, and register is Anil. @123, which is the password, and now you can see that we got the all these values displayed on the screen. So that's about the basic thing. In the upcoming video, we will learn more topics about Angular, and we will also learn the Angular form in depth. So keep in mind, don't forget to subscribe my channel and like this video.